So I was hoping to have something really cool to show you guys for the intro of this one. If you can't tell, I've been trying to do like cool holiday stuff for each video. Busted out all of our lights. These trees my dad actually gave me. They have LEDs on them. They light up. But they're really flimsy. I had them outside. They kept getting blown over by the wind. I gotta buy like some sandbags or something to hold them down. But I did get all of my lights out. I plugged them in. I test them. They worked. Went outside and I started putting them on the bushes and on the on my poles out here. I'm gonna show you guys real quick. Let me get this door open. So I managed to get this one up. I turned it on. It worked fine. I have a timer down here so they can automatically turn on. And then I took the time. I wrapped all the lights around this pole over here and I started going down. And then as soon as I plugged the lights in, half of them didn't work. And I spent like an hour trying to find that one bulb that was messing up the whole thing, and it just had no luck. So, no light show for you guys right now. Let's get started with the workout. All right, Nation, today's going to be quads and hamstrings. Now, if you haven't been keeping up with the entire series, be sure to check out the playlist link over here. If you've been enjoying the series so far, be sure to give this video a like, and don't forget to hit that subscribe button, because we got more good videos coming soon. Now, just like the other videos in this series, we're working with that reverse pyramid style workout. So we're gonna be starting 15 reps, 12, 10, 8, 6, 4, etc. on all the lifts to make sure we're hitting a lot of volume, but also hitting that strength gain as well. All right, Nation, let's get started with that first superset, which is going to be the front squat and Romanian deadlift. Now, as you guys can see, set one, 135 pounds, hitting 15 repetitions. For those of you who have been keeping up with this series, you know that we're doing a reverse pyramid style workout. So we're going to be increasing the weight as we drop the number of reps you're doing per set. Now for the front squat, you know, you want to make sure that you have your hands under the bar, keeping your elbows up nice and high, full range of motion all the way down, all the way up. Push your knees out to help open up your hips and to make sure they don't collapse in as you push through your heels and your hips to get back to the top of the movement. Now personally, you know, front squats is not my most favorite exercise. I do try to do it as much as possible. I try to work it into my normal leg routines. But I have tightness in my lats that kind of prevents me from getting my elbows super high, and all I need to do is just focus more on the exercise and stretch a bit more, and I'll be able to have better form. But my form's not bad here. I'm not saying it's bad. I'm just saying there's always room for improvement. Now moving on to the Romanian deadlift, starting off with 225. As you guys can see, as soon as I finished doing my set, put the bar on the ground, put the weight on, and got right into the movement. Now, for those of you who have a hard time figuring out the difference between a Romanian deadlift and a stiff leg deadlift, I'll put a video link in the top left-hand corner of the video. But as you guys can see, I'm sitting back as far as I can, slight bend in my knees, and as you sit back and you maintain that arch in your back, is super important. If you start to roll over and go into flexion, you're going to hurt your lower back, and you're not going to get the most out of the exercise. But as you sit back, you should be feeling the tightness in your hamstrings. If you're not feeling that tightness, then you've gone too heavy and you're not working your hamstrings as hard as you could be. So do that. And another thing too, try to keep your chin tucked in. Towards the end of this set, I didn't tuck it in as well as I should have, but I like to follow my body with my head. So keep that in mind as you're doing the exercise. There goes that.
So now we're going to get started with the second set. And what you have to do obviously now is pick the bar up, put it back on the rack, load your weight. I put on 155 for set two, and now we're going to do 12 repetitions. Now remember guys, you're only taking a 30 second rest period. So as you're taking the weights off and putting them back on, that is cutting into your rest period time. If you have to take a little bit longer of a rest period, that's okay. I'm not gonna lie, guys. This first superset took me about 20 minutes to do. I had to rest a little bit more in between each set because I was pushing myself pretty hard, which is the whole point of this routine. I tell you guys to take 30 second rest periods. Number one, because I really want you to focus on that 30 seconds. But I feel like if I tell you guys to take a minute or a minute and a half rest period, that's gonna easily turn into 2 minutes to 3 minutes. So by having you mentally focusing on that 30 seconds, even if you rest about a minute long, you're still gonna rest a lot less than you normally would if I told you to rest longer. So if you understood all that, that's amazing. Let's move on to the second set of the Romanian deadlift. Now, I decided to stick with 225 for the second set, mainly because I felt like I could have sat back a little bit more and had a little better form on my first set, and I wanted to make sure I got the most out of all my reps. And, you know, I did 15 reps in the first one. I'm doing 12 reps on this one. It's only 3 reps behind. I'm starting to fatigue from the first 2 sets of the front squats, so I want to have a nice solid form and really push through those hammies. And as you guys can see, every single repetition, arched back, sitting back as far as I can. I mean, you can see the tightness in the hamstrings as I do each rep if you pay attention to my legs. So keep that in mind as you're doing this. And now let's take a quick look at those calluses and see how they're looking.
Well, with a temporary fix, it's gonna last another 4 sets. I think we'll be all right. Minimal blood. Just keep it pushing.
Now moving on to set 3, 10 repetitions. I bumped the weight up to 165. Feeling pretty fatigued at this point. I mean, you're doing a lot of core work, believe it or not. I mean, you're not doing core work to the point where you're gonna build huge blocky abs. We already discussed that in my video talking about, you know, why people say certain things. We won't get into it. But anyways, you know, you're involving your core a lot here. You really need to focus on that internal belt. I'll post a video link in the top left-hand corner for the internal belt if you guys don't know what it is. But basically, by having to keep your core super tight on all the reps to perform the front squat and the Romanian, your entire core, your abs and your lower back, is being worked. So make sure you're increasing your weight, but don't go crazy, because we're doing short rest periods and we're really making sure we're doing full range of motion and proper form. Now, as you guys can see, as soon as you're done, put the weight down, change the weights, and then get right into the next set as fast as possible. So for set 3, 10 repetitions, doing 245 pounds now, and once again, I'm really focusing on my form, and now you guys can get a better view here. You can see that I'm trying to follow my body with my head. I'm not looking straight up, trying to maintain that neutral spine. And also, with the Romanian deadlift, you need to go about mid-shin with this exercise. Now, if you have good flexibility, I have pretty good flexibility. I can actually bring the bar all the way to the ground while still maintaining that arch in my back. You can do that as well, but if you don't have as good flexibility, and if you start to go past mid-shin and your back starts to go into flexion, then what you need to do is just stop mid-shin, or stop at whatever the point is where your back starts to go into flexion. And flexion is when your back starts to round over. So put the weight up, take off the heavy weight, or if you can leave 245 on there and throw it back up on that rack, then that's what you need to do. Me personally, I'm trying to save my energy, and I probably couldn't curl 245, but anyways, racked it back up. Moving on to the next set, set 4. 175, 8 repetitions. Guys, once again, focus on that proper form. Full range of motion. Go as low as your flexibility will allow you. And if you notice that you start to fail in these reps, or you're not going as low as you should because you're starting to get tired, I want you guys to rack that weight, lower it, and get back into the set and do the full range of motion. Okay? The more weight you add to these exercises isn't necessarily going to give you more gains if it's affecting your form. That's a problem a lot of people have. And if you need to stop, as you guys saw in the chest video, if you have to stop and rest a second and then get back into the set to complete all the reps with full range of motion, then that's what you need to do. So as you guys can see, finish the front squats, going into the next set of the Romanian deadlifts. Set 4, 265. Now we're gonna do 8 repetitions. So as you guys can see, you know, we're increasing the weight, but we're maintaining proper form all the way down, all the way up. And when I do Romanian deadlifts, even if I can touch the ground, I try to just barely touch the ground, because the most engagement you're gonna get in your hamstrings on this exercise, for me personally, is on the way up after you've already come to the top of the movement. So right here where I'm going down, I feel like I'm building that slingshot in my hamstrings, and if I happen to bounce the weight, it's going to take all of that, you know, tension out of my hamstrings. So if I barely touch the ground and then really focus on my hamstrings and pull myself back up, that's where I'm getting the most engagement. And at this point in the workout, guys, I'm getting super fatigued, quads are destroyed, hamstrings are destroyed, but you have to push through it. Take a minute, you know, think to yourself what you need to do to get it done. Put the weight back on the rack, take it off, put it back up for the front squat, and let's go into the last set of this superset. So for the last set, set five, 185 pounds, we're doing 6 repetitions. Really focus on that full range of motion, all the way down, all the way up. You guys can even see my legs are shaking a little bit on the way down and on the way up. So they're not collapsing, which is good. If they started to collapse in, I'd have to lower the weight, but they are starting to shake. The workout routine is kicking in. I mean, we've just done a lot of volume, and that's the goal. The more volume we put into these workouts, the more muscle breakdown we're gonna have, and we're gonna get a lot of growth. And by taking those short rest periods, we're able to really maximize the effectiveness of that volume, no matter what weight we're using. Right here, I'm just creating what I like to call a quarter pounder, leaving the 25 in the middle and putting the 45 on the outside. So for the last set here, 275 pounds, Romanian deadlift all the way down, all the way up. Now guys, this is your last set of this exercise, so I do want you to try to increase the weight a bit more than you normally would because it's the last set. You want to give it everything you've got. And even if you increase it too much and you happen to fail out, that's okay. You're only doing 6 repetitions. You can just pick that bar back up and finish the workout.
We're 22 minutes into the workout. These take a lot out of you, but try to push it as hard as you can. Move on to the next superset.
Is that your headphone right there?
I couldn't find the pause button. Couldn't find the pause button. Get on my face.
Now let's move on to the second superset. We're about 22 minutes into the workout. Seated leg curl, set 1, 15 reps, 115 pounds. Now you guys will notice that I put my hands between my thighs right here. What I'm actually doing is I'm taking my thumbs and I'm pushing into that pad that holds my legs down. Whenever I hold on to those handles, I don't really feel like I secure myself in the seat properly. But by pushing on this pad, I'm actually able to really force my hips back and secure my lower body. So all I'm doing is using my legs. Now, I don't want you guys to go too heavy on this exercise. I want you to make sure you're doing full range of motion and you're not using momentum to bring that pad down. I want you to go all the way down with each rep. Try to make the machine even click at the bottom. Have the weight stack touch the top. Then as soon as you're done, you're gonna go into the seated leg extension, and this is gonna be set 1 here. We're doing 15 repetitions, and I started off with 130 pounds. Now for me, this was a little too light, so what I did was I focused on a little bit of a slower negative, and I really focused on squeezing my quads at the top of the movement. But that's okay, guys. Remember, like I said, if you ever start off too light, you got plenty of time to catch up on the next sets to increase that weight. And again, with this one, guys, all the way up, all the way down. Try to make it to the weight stack almost touches on every rep.
Those were a little on the light side, but that's okay. We still got plenty of sets to catch up. Go a little heavier. That's beautiful.
Moving on to set 2, I didn't bump the weight up too much. I bumped it up to 145 because on this exercise in particular, it's really easy to start doing less and less range of motion with each rep as your hamstrings fatigue, and it's really easy to start throwing your body into the machine itself to bring the weight down. You don't want to do that. You want to feel those hamstrings contracting on every single rep. You want to feel that burn. And as you guys can see, I'm controlling it on the way up. As soon as I get the full extension at the top, I'm bringing my legs all the way down, thrusting my heels to the bottom of the machine. As soon as you finish, go on to the next exercise, which is once again the seated leg extension. I did increase the weight on this one up to 160 pounds. Now we're doing 12 repetitions. And believe it or not, I mean, there is proper form on this machine. A lot of people complain about knee pain when they do this. You want to make sure you set up the seat back far enough so that your knees are in line with the pivot point of the machine. which is right where that access is to the left of my knee right there. If you're seated too far forward, you're going to put a lot of pressure in your knee, and that's where you start to run into some issues. All right, Hermanites, let's keep it moving. Set 360 pounds, 10 repetitions here. Gonna go all the way down, all the way up. You guys can see by my face, you know, this is really starting to kick in. It's really starting to burn, and that's the whole point. I want you to also pay close attention to my feet. I'm trying to keep them as vertical as possible. If you tend to, you know, bow your toes out or in, try to avoid that, because I feel like when you bow your toes out, you don't get as much hamstring activation, and you start to rely more on momentum to do the actual exercise. Set 3 for the leg extension, 175 pounds, 10 repetitions. Really secure yourself into the seat when you get to this machine. Grab those handles and use that, and use your arms to pull yourself down into the seat so that you don't use momentum to throw the weight up. And even with this machine too, guys, try to keep your toes vertical. Keep them pointing towards the ceiling. Don't let your toes fall to the outside or the inside while you do this movement.
I'm not gonna bump this one up. I'm starting to get to that point where I use too much momentum. You don't wanna do that.
Moving on to set 4, 160 pounds again, 8 repetitions. Now, at this point in the workout, you should be starting to be feeling a lot of fatigue. You're going back and forth. You're really hammering your quads. You're really hammering your glutes. You know, not your glutes, you're really hammering your hamstrings. You're getting a lot of muscle fatigue here. And like I said, the goal with these routines, guys, it's not to put as much weight as you possibly can on every single machine. The goal here is to get a lot of volume and really get that muscle fatigue going. We are working a bit on strength because we are increasing the weight as we're dropping the rep ranges. But the overall goal here is to get in and out of the gym another 45 minutes and leave the gym feeling like you got a good workout and you are still going to make some gains. Now moving on to set 4 in the seated leg extension, 205 pounds. Now notice as people start to go heavier on this machine, they really start to use momentum and they don't go all the way down with every single rep. You want to make sure that weight stack is almost touching on each and every repetition. And as you guys can see, we're about 30 minutes into the routine. We're on set 5, 6 repetitions. Again, really focus on that form. If you have to take a little bit longer of a break in between these sets to make sure you get the full range of motion and your form's spot on, that's okay. If you can stick to that 30 seconds and go back, forth, back, forth, back, forth, you know, that's even better. That's great. That's exactly what I want you guys to do. And for these two machines, it might even be a bit easier if you have a workout partner while you're doing this, because obviously, you know, it's a gym, things get busy, people want to use the machines that you're using, and it's really hard to get those supersets in. And, you know, this was actually a really crowded time at the gym when I filmed this. So luckily, there was a leg extension machine right next to me that somebody else could use, and I was able to just go back and forth without really being bothered. And even if somebody wanted to jump in and work in between your sets, you know, that's fine. And don't be afraid to tell someone you're supersetting. People are really cool at the gym. Everyone's there to make gains. So if you need to do a superset and somebody else needs to use your machine, as soon as you finish, just go back to the machine you're using and be like, hey man, I'm doing some supersets. You know, I was over here. Is it cool if we just work together or we just, you know, tear this up? And I'm, you know, more than likely they're gonna say yes, unless they're a jerk. And if they're a jerk, then you just tell them it's your machine. Set 6, 235 pounds, 4 reps. This is the last set of this exercise, the last set of this superset. So really focus on squeezing those quads as hard as you can at the top of each and every rep.
It's a great superset. Your body's constantly wobbling forward and backward because your quads and hands are giving out. It feels pretty good. So far, you know, this workout's pretty exhausting. It's a lot of volume, it's very taxing on the legs, not really a lot of rest periods. That first superset really took me out. Then we're gonna move on to the last superset, which is gonna be more about reps. And it's just gonna leave you toasted, so. I wanna call it the taxi now, so it's ready for when you're done.
Now on to that final superset, guys. We're gonna do prone leg curls and reverse dumbbell stepping lunges. Set one here, 50 pounds, 10 repetitions. Now, I know what you guys are thinking. That's pretty light for this exercise. I know a lot of you guys probably hit like 150, 170 when you do this. I normally do as well. However, when you're doing so much volume and you're breaking down the muscle and you're taking short rest periods, your muscles are going to be fatigued. This exercise is a super easy exercise to rely on momentum to move that pad up and down. And I want to make sure you guys are doing full range of motion and you're activating your hamstrings as much as possible. So put it on a light weight and do the exercise properly before you increase the weight for the next set. Now moving on to the dumbbell reverse stepping lunge. I'm using 30 pounds. It's 10 repetitions, but it's 10 reps per side. I want to make sure you guys are keeping your chest up. And as you can see, I'm really focusing on getting 90 degree angles on both legs as I go down. So I'm keeping my form nice and tight. If you use a wide stance when you do this exercise, and what I mean by that is if you try to step back too far, you're going to work a bit more glutes and a little less quads. This is a quad and hamstring workout. We are targeting the glutes a bit, obviously, in some of these exercises, but I want you to put as much tension into those quads as possible. So keep your form tight and make sure you get those 90 degree angles.
It's my almost puke face.
All right, guys, moving on to set two. I bumped the weight up to 65 pounds. Make sure you only took a 30-second rest period between your sets. And as you guys can see, I'm focusing on really controlling my negatives, and I'm making sure that I'm bringing the pad all the way to my butt. Now, what you'll notice sometimes if it becomes too heavy is that when the weight goes all the way down, you might slingshot your hips into the pad to bring the pad on your ankles up to your butt. You don't want to do that. If you start doing that, you need to reduce the weight and focus on your full range of motion without using any momentum at all. You should feel like your hamstrings are on fire. As soon as you're done, go pick up your dumbbells. I'm going to stick with 30-pound dumbbells all the way through on these sets. It was a good weight for me. I could really focus on getting a lot more activation in my quads. I could really focus on that tight form, getting those tight 90-degree angles. And, you know, that's what we're going for here. We're going for short rest periods. I feel like if I went heavier, if I went 35s or even 40s, that little increase in weight would actually fatigue me out more to the point where I wouldn't be able to take that 30-second rest period and get the next set in as fast as I wanted to. So that's a factor when you're picking your weights for these exercises. It's not about how much weight you can do, because I can do obviously more than 30 pounds for this exercise. It's about how much weight you can do to complete the set with proper form and also stick to that 30-second rest period. So if you're not used to doing routines like this, it might take you a few tries to figure out exactly how your body responds to this type of training. But you'll catch on quick. You're Hermanites and you train hard.
When your muscles get that fatigued, it just takes a lot of concentration to get all the reps and get your form right. That's good. That's what you guys want. You want fatigue. You want to feel weak. You want to feel like you're ready to give up. You want to feel like you're going to puke, because that means the workout's going well and you want to push yourself to that level. Now let's finish this up. We got one more set left.
All right, with 39 minutes in, let's move on to the last set. Set three, I bumped the weight up to 80 pounds. And in case you guys haven't noticed, on this superset, we're sticking with 10 reps on every single set. Again, guys, you'll notice similar to here, like on the seated leg curl, I'm keeping my feet as vertical as possible. It might not seem like a big deal to you, but it's much harder to keep your feet in this position and perform the repetitions. If you start to bow your toes out, you're gonna notice a little less hamstring activation, and it's also due to you using more momentum because you're too fatigued to do the reps properly. Keep your feet straight, activate those hamstrings, move right on to the next set of the last exercise to complete this. If you guys wanna bump the weight up a bit here, it's the last set of the last exercise, that's cool. For me, my quads were fried. I decided to stick with 30 pounds to make sure I get 10 solid reps on each leg. Once again, guys, not slacking in form. It is the last set. You wanna make sure everything goes as perfect as possible. At this point, I even tried, you know, tightening my upper body, my arms, and my core to make sure that I'm getting as much out of this as possible. See those tight 90 degree angles? I'm stepping back. I could probably keep my chest a bit higher when doing this exercise and try to be more vertical with my upper body, but for the most part, the way I'm doing this is totally fine. The form is spot on, but as you guys can see, I'm starting to waver a little bit. I'm getting a little fatigued. My face is starting to change, starting to get those crazy eyes, starting to scrunch my eyebrows. Erica likes to make fun of me when I scrunch my eyebrows like that. And then my infamous smile. I like to smile when I'm hurting. Smiling means that it's working well. Workout's over. 41 minutes, 13 seconds. Now that's a leg workout, Nation.
Well, it was under 45. That's for sure. Not by much. That was like the perfect weight for that last exercise. It's like getting to my breaking point on that last set. So you guys have it. It's your next installment in the holiday workout series. Remember, playlist link is right here. If you've been enjoying the series so far, be sure to go down, like this video, give it a thumbs up, leave a comment in the comment section below. If you want to keep up with the entire workout series, it's a full week program that'll get you in and out of the gym in under 45 minutes to give you the best workout when you're short on time. So remember, the playlist link is right here. For more great tips, exercises, routines, and meal plans, be sure to join us on ScottHermanFitness.com. And as always, more good stuff coming soon. See you guys. I just don't know what to do with my body right now.
I know.
Really, I feel like you're gonna throw up everywhere.
That'd be nice to get on camera.
Nice projectile vomit across the gym. That'd be good. That would get a thumbs up. That'd be like a standalone video. Guys.